our next guest is an Aussie filmmaker who's worked with Steven Spielberg and Ted Turner. If that's not impressive enough, well, her work has also included Mother Teresa and the Dalai Lama and many other great spiritual leaders. Oh. Please welcome to the show Christina Stevens.
Hi.
Hi.
The way you came to work with Mother Teresa, it started with a dream, didn't it?
Yes, and I'm not Catholic. And what I knew about her, you could pour into a teacup. I mean, but she came to me in a dream and she said, if you wish to film me, I will let you, but you must come soon. Wow. Because it was well known that she didn't allow anyone. She didn't like cameras. She didn't allow them in her space.
No interviewing.
No, because she felt it really played into an ego thing and she wasn't... She certainly
was
not about
that. When she said come soon, was that near the time of her death?
It was 4 years before she passed, but you'd have to say that...
She was quite old at that
point. I needed to hear something like that, or else I'd say, oh, well, you know, next week I'll go, or I'll think about this, you know. But that was such a call. I mean, I literally dropped everything and I said, I'm going to India to film Mother Teresa, and everyone went... You're crazy.
Or because you had this dream.
Or because I had this dream.
No confirmation from her.
No, nothing.
But you also listened and acted on that.
I did.
So what happened when you got to India?
Well, she wasn't in the country.
And did you have another dream?
Well, actually, I had spoken to her on the phone, and the day before I was leaving California, because I was working in Hollywood, I got a fax from her office that said, don't come, don't bring your film crew, Mother will not allow filming. Mm. And I said, Who sent this to me? And my assistant said, Sister Priscilla. And I said, well, since it wasn't Mother Teresa, I'm still going. I mean, I knew that I was called and that I had to respond to this call.
And then but you still went, she wasn't there, but you began working in one of her sort of orphanages.
In her orphanage and in her home for the dying. Yeah. And I learned so much there. That was the real gift. It wasn't going to get the film. The gift was really learning what she was doing and learning about love and how unconditional, compassionate love is such a deep thing that all human beings have. I mean, this is what we're born with.
So how did it all come together? So when was the moment you said, all right, you're in, let's do it?
Oh, my God, I had 3 private meetings with her. She kept saying no. Every time I burst into tears, not a very professional thing to do. Let me tell you, this is not what we do.
But you got to meet her. You got to meet her.
And this photo, was this when you first met her?
No, this is during filming, and she had forgotten a little, and she looked over to me, and I raced in the middle, and I said, remember, Mother, we talked about the revolution of love. And she said, ah, yes. And she looked at the camera and she said, I call it a revolution of love, and that was exactly what I needed. You know, I was only making a 2-minute message that was going to air around the world, which it did. It won awards, but it aired in troubled parts of many places in the world.
And what was that message?
Her message was love begins at home.
Right.
And if we love each other, we can build love within our house, we can spread throughout the world. Peace, unity and love with each other. Exactly.
So it must have been an enormous change for you to go from Hollywood, where you were living in Steve McQueen's ranch, formerly owned by Steve McQueen. and you were working with people like Ted Turner and Steven Spielberg.
Yes. Both visionaries.
But what was it like working for men like that?
Fantastic.
What did you learn from them? You learned love from Mother Teresa.
Love from Mother Teresa. I learned a lot of discipline from Steven Spielberg, creative discipline. Mm. And from Ted, well, I'm still learning. I'm on the board of one of his foundations, and he's a philanthropist, bar none, like none other. I mean, his gift of $1 billion to the United Nations was, I mean, no one else had... He began this massive giving from wealthy people. But Ted is an environmentalist, and I learn a lot about that because I speak at the UN often on sustainable practices, as well as consciousness raising and youth empowerment. But I'm constantly learning from Ted.
Why did you go to Hollywood? What drove you? Because you came from Australia originally,
yes,
right? And you went to
Sydney
LA.
I was a Sydney girl, yes.
And just thought, I'll go.
Over there?
What was that? Well, when I was here, I was working on television commercials. My first job was Girl Friday with John Singleton.
Oh.
So, yes. Anyhow.
Many lessons.
Yes, many lessons.
Life.
Oh, absolutely.
A spasm?
Not before Spasm. We were Barry Curry.
Oh,
this
way
was
back.
When John, yes, mm. I was his Girl Friday.
Right. Okay. So you were in advertising?
Well, I was, but I quickly moved from being a Girl Friday into a writer, and I was 17 and my secretary was 33. So it was kind of, it was
what
a little.
A life. My goodness.
That's
and you're
far.
Still learning and spreading this such yes. important message of love.
Yes.
What's
yeah.
the what's oh. the next project? Anything?
Yes.
Oh. Quickly tell
yes,
us.
Yes, I'm working on A Call to Love, which is children throughout the world. We're going to unify and project it onto the wall of the United Nations.
Wow.
Wow. And it's children calling from all religions of the world blending into one.
Lovely.
Wow. Mm.
What an extraordinary, extraordinary life that you've led. Christina, thank you very much for coming on the show. You've written a book, of course, about your experiences called Love, the Saint and the Seeker. Christina Stevens, everyone.
Wow.
Thank you.